So we move on to chapter 6 now, which is the heart of the LFS system, or heart of building the LFS system. So we need to mount, or rather make some directories, create some initial device nodes that don't exist, mount some virtual file systems, and enter the true environment. So now we create some more directories. Some symlinks. Some configuration files. Relog in, we should get rid of this I have no name message. And finally some other files that need to exist to be used. So first thing here we build is the Linux headers, or install rather. So I've got one small change to make, and then we install the headers as before. Some man pages. And now we move on to building Glibc. Despite what I said earlier on about some add-ons, there is actually an add-on for Glibc which we're going to use now by the looks of it. Many programs support the IDN and require the full libIDN library on this add-on. Okay, so we just extract this from within the Glibc directory, and then carry on with the build, making some changes. Create a build directory as usual. Configure for the build. And start the build. So this takes about 7 to 10 minutes roughly. Right, so that's finished building. We can run some tests now as we did before. And these take approximately 15 minutes for the looks of it. Okay, so that's finished checking. Let's check for the errors. And you can see we've got one annex c.out and this test cancel again, which it says will fail when using the 4.1 series of GCC. So that's good. There's no unexpected failures there. So let's just carry on with the installation then. Right, so although I'm not planning on running any further tests, there are still the bin utils and GCC tests to run because I'm doing the the tool chain test, so I need to put all these in. And I need to put in one for my own locale, so I'll just edit that one. And carry on with the configuration. Run TZ select. So I want Europe and UK. Yes, that's correct. So I copy that in, paste that extra bit in, and then I can copy the rest in and configure the dynamic loader. So that's Glibc done. And move on to what's next, bin utils, is it? No, readjusting the tool chain, of course. So we run these commands again. Adjust the specs. And then retest the compilation. And you can see now it's the LD Linux SO library is in the place you'd expect it to be. And that ties up with what's on the screen. Do some further checks. That looks okay. And that's fine. That's all good. And that's correct. And finally, yep, that's good as well. So we'll just tidy up.